Hey guys, what's going on? Good morning from Dhaka, Bangladesh. 1:30 here. I'm doing a few videos for you, and I have done a couple of like individual reviews. I've been doing some individual reviews that I've been buying to create content, and I'll do perhaps an extra episode soon that what I'm doing, update sort of on my channel, because I'm not the most organized guy. I don't sometimes know what I'm doing. I don't know. I'm very unpredictable myself, so I don't know what I'm gonna plan next few days. So today I will do this review, then I'll do one more list. If I have any energy left, I'll do that extra video, otherwise no. But in general, in short, I've been doing some individual reviews for you, so you don't feel like I'm just doing those gimmicky top 10, top 15. I know I need those videos, honestly speaking. I'm always frank with you, to get views, I mean, to get paid a little bit better from YouTube. You have to do those videos so they get you views, you know, people enjoy. You know, many people, they enjoy many fragrances in one video, but individual reviews is what I really want to do, okay? So you can learn from another fragrance, learn about another fragrance, okay? So today, Van Cleef & Arpels. I have been having this for a very long time, about a month, but it's been, you know, not well, and then tired and all those things, and a lot of fragrances came running. I couldn't finish it. Thanks to Avik Bhai for lending me this masterpiece. This is called Orchid Leather, okay? And I think this is a 75 ml bottle from the Collection Extraordinaire. I have covered few from this line. I'll leave a link below. Please check out. And also, Van Cleef & Arpels is a house that I really like. Exotic house. They do jewelry, you know, watches. Very posh house. They are more luxurious than some niche houses. When it comes to their creations, Van Cleef, some of their watches, they keep them in the museum because they are worth millions, right? Sometimes it's nice to study and, you know, learn. So this is the packaging. I smelled this during one of the, like, last Eid or a couple of months back. We had this huge deal going on in Sandara, one of our big retails, and they were selling this for good prices after the discount. So I wanted to buy this and also Orchid Vanille, but then I changed my mind because I was going for more like 100 ml bottles. This is the only reason I didn't get it, but this is a phenomenal fragrance. Absolute love. Check out the, I think there's some pattern on the bottle. Van Cleef & Arpels, I don't know if it'll show. Yeah, there you go. Van Cleef & Arpels, they have this tower. This nice, this thing is raised. The name, everything. I took out the bottle already. And these are made in France, 17% volume. Very, very beautiful packaging, niche presentation. And I think I really like this. If you drop it, this is solid presentation. It will protect the bottle. The bottle here is very beautiful. I've shown you some before. This is how that bottle looks. Elegant, nicely cut, straightforward, and very, very sharp, you know. Not sharp as in like sharp edges, but sharp as in smart, okay? Nice little sticker. And these are the kind of presentations I really adore and respect, because they keep it minimal yet elegant, okay? Nice little tag of Van Cleef & Arpels, the name, the black bottle. You can see through the bottle. I think if you put LED, you can see through. Kind of like a fingerprint magnet, but it's okay. Cap is really good quality. I think it's a ceramic, or I don't know what it is. It's very high class cap, and the atomizer looks like that. So I have it on the paper. Let's spray some of this and talk about it. Just go one spray, which is adequate. It's very long lasting fragrance, and longevity on this fragrance, you can expect this line, Extraordinaire, and some of the more upper class ones from this lines, they're gonna last, okay? Do not worry about longevity. The dark bottles, they all last, okay? And some of the other ones also last very long time, except perhaps there's an iris based one. It's a little bit lighter, but still, one is smelling like Neroli Portofino, or there's one like Neroli Amara, one is the Amande. I forgot those names, but still, they are very long lasting because they are freshies. Coming back to this, when I smelled it, I fell in love with it so much. It's one of those fragrances I really love because it's sweet, it's mysterious, it's dark, and it's said to be similar to something from Bikilian. I think it's, I forgot the name. Was it? Nah, I don't remember. Sorry. Now it is getting old. This is one of the downsides, right? It's similar to Kilian's Black Phantom, okay? I reviewed that long time back, but I forgot the smell. But this one has some notes. Some people suggest this is similar to Red Tobacco, Plum Japonais, or something of Tom Ford, Valentino Vumo, Noir Absolu. Yeah, you see those suggestions, or something Leighton, perhaps, yeah, or Carlisle, yeah. But this one has nose breakdown, very simple, okay? Vanilla Absolute, Plum, Labdanum, Incense, and Cardamom. The right nose breakdown, you know, like whatever is important, they put in there. No extra additional notes, just to make it gimmicky, like 16 other notes which stand for nothing. This one, in short, you smell the plum right away, and I get kind of like a boozy sweetness from it, okay? And they don't make anything of boozy, but it gets sweeter. It gets kind of like a nice vanillic property after a while, but the spices are not overbearing. What I like about it, you know, it's not like Black Orchid by Tom Ford, okay? It's not that. But it's similar to maybe Valentino Uomo Intense, because there's a sweetness, intense sweetness, but it holds it back. It's very polished. It's, think of like a pebble that is this smooth, okay? Like a pebble. And this is very nicely smoothened everywhere. There's no rough edges. So even if though it's a sweet, loud perfume, it doesn't really scream or make it offensive. You know, if I can make it clear that you, if you wear this, people are not going to be offended. Like, let's say you sprayed three times your Black Orchid. People may feel like, what did you do? If you sprayed some Shura on you, people will be like, really, bro? Why are you wearing Shura in the office? If you put this on in the office, people will say, that smells nice. That smells sweet, but I like it. You know, that's kind of a beauty in this. It's a strong, but yet never screams. And if you think it's a mute fragrance, it's not that. It's just projecting so beautifully, very elegant. It's just holding back all the right properties. Doesn't become wild, but very strong. People come near you, they smell you, and it projects like a mofo. Man, I smell this on a guy. I think, who was wearing this? It was projecting so beautifully. The moment it hits the AC from his neck, it was transporting to me. So performance is just crazy good on this. 75 ml is not an issue, absolutely. This will last you a very long time. You just literally need two sprays. When to wear this? Nighttime, and especially if winter comes. This is the kind of fragrance we wear where you wear. This is the fragrance we wear where we wear. Same occasion where you wear Dior Homme Intense, Van Cleef & Arpels, Midnight in Paris, something like La Nuit de l'Homme, okay? The warmth, the sweetness. I don't find it very similar to the By Kilian, to be honest. The By Kilian one is nice, but that one is a lot more aggressive, a lot more loud. By Kilian's, like Kilian fragrances on me, like Angel Share, is very loud. It's sweet, I love it, but some of the other ones, the boozy ones, spicy ones, wood ones, leather ones, sometimes they choke me. Sometimes I feel they are unwearable. I'm just telling you my two cents, you know, not everybody's gonna agree with me, but I have a By Kilian review coming up soon, which was alone on for a long time. This is gonna be, I think, Black Phantom, or what is the fragrance called? I forgot the name. This is a atomizer I borrowed from my brother Shubhai. Let's keep it as a secret. We'll see what you get. So that one is one of the loud ones. This one right here, if you buy this, if you wear this, you can wear this for your date. If you're a lady, you can wear this. If you're a man, you can wear this. Both of you are rocking this at the same time, no issue. You are wearing a tux, the lady is wearing a gown. Both of you can rock this. There's nothing absolute manly. There's nothing absolute feminine. This is right in the middle. Perfectly unisex. Very high class. And some of you will be like, you know, snob by brand. You know, this is not like a niche brand. This is no Frederick Malbro. You know, I don't wear Van Cleef. They're okay. If the same juice released from Frederick Malle or any of those luxury house or niche or something, indie house, people would go gaga over this. This is the quality of the fragrance. Waxy, beautiful, sweet, vanilla. And it reminds me of something like Tom Ford Noir de Noir, okay? Not same. That one has rose. But the beauty, you know, that's within, this fragrance offered me that, you know? Love it. Absolute love. Absolute beauty to my average designer nose, I guess, you know, I like to take it as a compliment, you know. Very sweet, very long lasting, and I don't get that much leather from this. It's just the orchid, really beautiful. Do not be fooled, this is not a Black Orchid clone. Lovely perfume, okay. If you ask me to recommend you one from this line, this would be highly recommended. This one gets perfection, 10 out of 10 in my book. Check it out, Orchid Leather by Van Cleef & Arpels. Thank you so much, Avik Bhai, for your loan. I'm really grateful that I could cover this perfume, and I have a sample, but I actually wanted to show you the full presentation. Thank you so much for watching. I think I'll do the list and I'll upload them. Take care. Good night from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Bye-bye.